Let us now focus on another organ system, that is immune system. The immune system is the body's defense against bacteria, viruses and other pathogens that may be harmful. The immune system is also known as the lymphatic system. Its main job is to make and move lymph, a clear fluid that contains white blood cells, which helps the body fight infection. The lymphatic system also removes excess lymph fluid from bodily tissues and returns it to the blood. Organs and tissues of the immune system include tonsils and adenoids, lymph, lymph nodes, lymph vessels, thymus, spleen, appendix, and bone marrow. Tonsils and adenoids. These are also part of the lymphatic system. These are located at the back of the throat. These are sentinels that protect the digestive system and the lungs from bacteria and viruses. Lymph. Lymph is a fluid that circulates throughout the body in the lymphatic system. Lymph nodes. These are small, bean-shaped glands that produce lymphocytes, filter harmful substances from the tissues, and contain macrophages, which are cells that digest cellular debris, pathogens, and other foreign substances. Major groups of lymph nodes are located in the tonsils, adenoids, armpits, neck, groin, and mediastinum. Lymph vessels. These are valved structures that carry lymph around the body. Thymus. Thymus is located in the chest in an area in front of the heart and directly behind the sternum. It is a pyramid-shaped organ that is involved in producing T cells or lymphocytes, which protects the body from the infection. Spleen. Spleen is located on the left side of the body, just above the kidney, under the ribs. The spleen plays multiple supporting roles in the body. It acts as a filter for blood as part of the immune system. Older red blood cells are recycled in the spleen, and platelets and white blood cells are stored there. It also helps fight certain kinds of bacteria that cause pneumonia and meningitis. Appendix. It is a thin dead-end tube measuring about 3 to 4 inches in length, and it hangs from the cecum. It tells the lymphocytes exactly where they have to head over to attack infection. Bone marrow. It is a soft tissue and is located inside the bones. It is the birthplace of all blood cells, including white blood cells or lymphocytes, which are the main fighters in the immune system. We will move on to another organ system, integumentary system. The integumentary system acts as a protective barrier for the human body against microorganisms, dehydration, and injuries caused by the outside environment. Additionally, the integumentary system regulates body temperature. Organs of the integumentary system include the skin, nails, hair, and exocrine glands. Skin. It is the largest component of this system. It is an extensive sensory organ which forms an outer protective coat around the entire external surface of the body. It is composed of three layers of tissue, the epidermis, dermis, and subcutaneous fat. Nails. Nails protect the sensitive tips of fingers and toes. These aren't necessary for living, but they do provide support for the tips of the fingers and toes, protect them from injury, and aid in picking up small objects. The nail consists of nail root, the portion of the nail under the skin. Nail body. The visible pink portion of the nail, the white crescent at the base of the nail, is the lunula. The hyponychium secures the nail to the finger. The cuticle or eponychium is a narrow band around the proximal edge of the nail end. Free edge. The white end that may extend past the finger. Hair. Hair grows everywhere on the human body, except the palms of the hands, soles of the feet, and lips. The functions of hair include protection and sensing light touch. Structure of the skin. The following are the three important layers of the skin: epidermis, dermis, subcutaneous fat. Click each tab to know more. Epidermis. Epidermis is the outermost layer for protection. The thickness of epidermis varies in different types of skin. The thickness of skin is low, 0.5 mm in eyelids, and higher, 1.5 mm in palm. Epidermis contains sweat pores and small hair. Epidermis contains the melanin pigment. The color of the skin is due to the pigment melanin. It makes the skin darker or brighter. This pigment gets stimulation when exposed to sunlight. The more melanin the person has, the darker the skin will be. The skin becomes darker in order to protect the other layers from the harmful effects of light. Skin contains separate receptors like tactile receptors for touch, Pacinian corpuscles for pressure, and nociceptors for temperature, etc. There are different types of skin colors. Epidermis has five layers. They are stratum corneum, stratum lucidum, stratum granulosum, stratum spinosum, stratum basale. The topmost layer, stratum corneum, or confined layer, contains dead cells that are shed about every 2 weeks. Middle granular layer contains living cells. The bottom layer, stratum basale, has cells that are shaped like columns. In this layer, the cells divide constantly and push the already formed cells into higher layers. As the cells move into the higher layers, they flatten and eventually die. Dermis. Dermis lies below the epidermis. It is made up of thick elastic connective tissue. The thickness of dermis also varies depending upon the location of the skin. Dermis layer is made up of blood vessels, sweat glands, sebaceous glands, hair follicles, nerve endings. Blood vessels. Blood vessels in dermis supply nutrients and oxygen to the skin and take away all the cell waste and cell products. Sweat glands. The average person has about 3 million sweat glands. Sweat glands are small tubular structures of the skin that produces sweat. Sebaceous glands. Sebaceous or oil glands are attached to hair follicles and can be found everywhere on the body except for the palms of the hands and the soles of the feet. These glands secrete an oily substance called sebum. This sebum protects the body against an overgrowth of bacteria and fungi on the skin. The sebum helps in keeping the skin waterproof. Hair follicles. The hair follicle is a tube-shaped sheath that surrounds the part of the hair that is under the skin and nourishes the hair. Nerve endings. The dermis layer also contains pain and touch receptors that transmit sensation of pain, itch, pressure, and information regarding temperature to the brain for interpretation. For example, when you touch a hot object, the nerve endings present in the skin transfer the message to the brain. Because of this, we are able to remove our hand immediately. Subcutaneous fat. The bottom layer of skin is the subcutaneous fat layer. Subcutaneous fat is the fatty or adipose tissue lying directly under the skin layers. This fat helps to insulate the body from heat and cold. The fat is stored in living cells called fat cells. The thickness of fat varies from an inch to several inches. It contains not only fatty tissues but also blood vessels which supply the skin with oxygen and nerves. Functions of subcutaneous fat. Subcutaneous fat attaches dermis to your muscles and bones. It helps in the growth of nerve cells and blood vessels. Controls body temperature. Stores the fats. From the image on screen, identify the parts of the structure of the skin by dragging and dropping the respective labels. The first one is done for you.